the life of Walt Disney. Not because I, you know, we went to Orlando this summer. I didn't go to Disneyland, so it's not like it's the place that thrills me. It's the man behind the place that intrigues me. Because I wanted to know something about a man who dared the world to dream a dream and said that all of your dreams could come true. Now, I'm not endorsing his life or trying to put him on any pedestal. It's just that he was an innovator and he was extremely creative. And he's just interested in it. I'm not trying to promote anything there. Just, I know one man's dream can become another man's experience. And then hear me when I say your dream is not just for you. It never is. Your dream is about those that God has placed around you. I'm trying to get to where I'm going. Just hold on just another moment. Your dreams were never about you. So if you're a carrier this morning like Mary, when God speaks something into your life, it's never just for you. I would pour my life out for this church in this community. And all the time, look at my kids and my children's children and my children's children's children and say on our watch, could we see God raise up an interracial, multicultural, multigenerational, next level church? Yeah. Could we dream to believe God to raise up a house not of hurt and not of division, but a house where everybody, whether you wear jeans or you wear a suit, whether you have long hair, short hair, regardless of the color of your skin, regardless of what you did last night, can we see a house raised up where people could be loved to life instead of hurt to death? You can't do it for you, do it for the generations that are coming behind us. See, I realize my dream isn't just about me. It's very little to do with me. Let me say this before I go on to Joseph. Genesis 2:16 tells us that God always puts the right people in our lives. And he often puts in our lives people around us that are not just like us. When God created Eve, he put somebody in Adam's life that was not just like him. So those that we desire to attract that are like us most oftentimes will not complete us. They will compete with us. Here's a word this morning I want you to write down somewhere, partnership. It is the first word I want to talk to you about, Joseph, partnership. Because as long as we think church, every other church around us is our competition. And yet, I will tell you, saints, here's the reality. I never talk to other pastors and never talk about people like we're in competition for one another. I tell people all the time, if you find something that's feeding your life greater someplace else, I'm not trying to get in your way. Because it's not about church, it's about kingdom. But if we don't just talk church but can talk kingdom, then we're not competition, we are partners with one another. And if we can be partners with one another, and if we can learn to clearly define what it is God's saying amongst us, then we can begin to attract the opportunities that will bring our dreams to pass. Now here's a great revelation. Don't get surprised by this, but hear me when I say great dreams need great money.